Greetings, users and losers. You know who you are. Down here on Earth, we consume non-stop. We eat energy and convert it into more of us. When we ate all the coal, we started on the oil. When we ate all the oil, we started on Pittsburgh ash. And we'll go on eating until we make so many humans there won't be anything left to eat but each other. What if someone told you we're doing that already? Pittsburgh ash rains down on us and we're so hungry for it we don't care what it costs. But there is a cost. The corporations that rape Pittsburgh to feed us that sweet, sweet ash do everything they can to crush expenses and maximize profits. Everything that does not produce profit is an expense, including the blood of human beings. The more you learn about this, the harder it becomes to ignore. This is why you are not told the truth. Little is known about the working conditions in the mining stations at Pittsburgh. But history shows that truth cannot be contained forever. It strains against the bars of its prison until, inevitably, they begin to crack. One such crack was revealed when one of Pittsburgh's rapists, JSEC Energy Alliance, crushed one expense too many. Cutting back on health screenings allowed a strain of Ebola to ravage their fuel mining station and take down its entire crew. There was no option but to purge the station into hard vacuum, bodies and fuel alike. With no options for replacement, JSEC lost its claim on Pittsburgh. That station is still there, bought for a song, by Colton Ferris. It is now his own personal space mansion. His floating disease palace. He should feel right at home. You'd think that would be warning enough not to play it cheap anymore. But never underestimate the greediest people in the universe. They were quick to find the cheapest labor on Earth. It was ready and waiting for them in the prison system. Once, prisons were run by our government. But as wealth concentrated at the top and drove everyone else to the bottom, tax revenue plummeted. Government starved for money and the garage sale was on. Now there isn't a single federally owned, non-profit prison left in the untied states of America. Every inmate is labor capital to be bought and sold. They can work off their sentence slowly, in a box, on Earth, or slightly faster, in a can, in space. Thanks to the courts, criminals are delivered directly to the corporate doorstep. For a finder's fee, of course. See this for yourself. Do your own Scrabble search for criminal convictions within any corporate district in America. Compare that list to employee records. When you find the same name in both lists, check their address. Chances are high that it will not be on Earth. One retired judge after another has talked about changes to sentencing guidelines. This is no coincidence. Corporations still labeled their profit-earning prisons a correctional system, but we'll call it what it is, slavery. This is still only a crack in the bars. Not even prison labor is cheap enough for them. Consider how expensive it is to employ a human in space. Your body is a liability. It needs air and sleep. It needs food and water. Hair grows, teeth decay, organs and muscles fall apart. How does an employer crush these costs? Simple. Forced electrolysis. Forced teeth removal. Forced sterilization. And these are only the alterations they have admitted to. Apply what we know. It costs thousands of dollars per pound to lift a human into space. But use your imagination. Then consider the implications of forced weight loss. In this particular area, corporate labor policy becomes suspiciously opaque. Until truth finally breaks through its prison bars, there are two more things you should know. First, despite promises of parole, not one convict has ever come back from Pittsburgh in the 10 years since this program started. Second, there is a corporate buzzword for those who are pushed through the courts and prisons into de facto slavery at Pittsburgh. When the ash comes down for us to gobble up, take note of the bitter aftertaste. That's the taste of human life.